When looking at the patient, we widened our scope and found that there are many people and product services contributing to the process of healing. We call them the actors. For example, the patient and the specialist, both in the context of healthcare. Mapping those actors can be done in many different ways. For example, what is often used is a network representation with nodes and edges between the nodes. And nodes being people or processes, and edges being connections of any kind. For example, causality between the nodes, or interaction between the nodes, or influence to the healthcare process. Another way to map the actors is to put the patient in the center of concentric circles, with actors close to the patient nearby, for example, the specialist, and less direct visible actors, like organizations, further away from the patient. However, the drawback of these representations is that they lack time as a factor, while the process of healing from a disease has many different stages over time. For example, the rehabilitation phase, or the diagnostic phase, or being in the operating theater. By adding an axis of time to the axis of actors that we already have, we can extend our representation of the patient journey. And by doing so, we are able to identify all the potential touch points for services in the entire healthcare process of the patient. In other words, we zoom out in time and in actors to obtain the bigger picture that's necessary for these complex design innovation problems. Therefore, step two of creating the patient journey is to add the different phases to the journey.